Making Adobe Acrobat Files Accessible. Presented by the Civil Rights Office of the Texas Health and Human Services Commission.
Making Accessible PDF Tables.
Part 2. How to Remediate a Simple Table. Introduction. In Part 1 of this series, you learned about things to consider and things to avoid in a Microsoft Word document with tables to make it easier to remediate when you convert it to an Adobe PDF file. If you follow the steps in Part 1, you will only need to do a few verifications and minor changes to ensure your PDF can be read by anyone using assistive technology. These verifications and changes are referred to as Accessibility Remediation. There are three types of tables that can be remediated in Adobe Acrobat Pro: simple tables, complex tables, and corrupted tables. In this tutorial, we'll discuss how to make a simple table accessible in Adobe Acrobat Pro. Accessibility remediation of complex and corrupted tables will be discussed in Parts 3 and 4 of this training series. If a simple table from a source document like Microsoft Word is formatted, as discussed in Part 1, Things to Consider Before You Begin, it will typically convert correctly within Adobe Acrobat Pro. However, there are a few times when a document does not convert correctly, for various reasons, for example, poor grid structure or excessive text in cells. As a result, the table will have to be fixed inside of Adobe Acrobat Pro by ensuring that it has the correct header information. Who is at the head of the table? Tables must have headers in order for them to be read correctly by both sighted users and those who use assistive technologies, like the JAWS screen reader. Before we get started, let's explain why headers are so important. Look at this example table. If I were to say $1.45 a pound by itself, that would not mean anything to anyone. However, if I were to say $1.45 a pound for bananas, that would be more meaningful, but it still would not give us the complete picture of the content in that cell for this table. Finally, if I were to say $1.45 a pound for bananas from HEB, that would give us the complete picture of the content in this cell. This is why table headers are so important to a table, because it gives the complete picture of what's in the given cell. Moreover, assistive technology like JAWS uses this information to connect the dots and read the data in a meaningful way. Mind your table manners. Now that we know the importance of headers, let's see how to correct our table manners. In this example, the header rows and header columns were lost during the Word to PDF conversion. How do we know that without testing in JAWS? On the right side of the screen, select the Full Check link, and in the Accessibility Checker Options dialog box that appears, click on the Start Checking button. In the Accessibility Checker panel that opens, on the left side of the screen, select the plus sign next to the Tables to expand it. While the TH, Table Header, and TD, Table Data check passed, simply because one of them is used in the table, the headers option failed because the table does not have any headers defined. Select the small triangle on the left side of the screen to open up the Tools panel. Select the Tags icon to view the tag tree. In the tag tree, select Tags, Sect, Table, and the first TR, or table row, as needed to expand the table element so that you can see the series of TD tags for the first row. All of the tags for the first TR, or table row, are designated as TD, or table data tags, instead of TH, or table header tags, as they should be. They should correspond to the header row in the table. Table for 2. Let's see how we can set the table for 2, a table with a header row and a header column. Select the Accessibility button and then select the Read Order button to open the Turo, Touch Up Reading Order, dialog box. Select the Show Page Content Groups checkbox below the Table Editor button. The Table Editor button is disabled because no table is currently selected. The table on the page is assigned reading order tag numbers, and they become visible. Select any one of these reading order tag numbers, and you should see the Table Editor button will be enabled. Select the Table Editor button, and a red grid appears overlaid on top of the table that corresponds to the underlying table structure. You may notice that the overlying red grid does not exactly match the visual grid lines of the original table. Don't let this bother you. It's an Adobe feature. Select all of the cells on the top row, either by drawing a lasso in the middle and across all of the rows with the mouse, or holding down the Shift key and clicking on each of the cells in the top row. Right-click on any one of the highlighted cells and select Table Cell Properties to open the Properties dialog box. Double-check that the Header Cell Radio button is selected, and then set the Scope drop-down menu to Column. This will make sure that the screen reading software will know that these cells are column headers and instruct assistive technology to look down the table, beginning with the selected cell. Now select the OK button. A faint pink highlight appears on the top row to let you know that this row has been converted to table headers. These are now TH, or table header tags, in the tags tree. Repeat the previous steps for the first column cells that make up the row headers: pears, peaches, bananas, and apples. This time, set the scope to row so that the screen readers look across the table, beginning with the leftmost cell as the header. Now, the header row and the header column that were once tagged as TD, or table data tags, are now correctly tagged as TH, or table header tags. The icons next to the TH tags have all changed to having one small red cell. Now, select the Full Check link to open the Accessibility Checker Options dialog box, and select the Start Checking button at the bottom of the dialog box. On the left side of the screen, the Accessibility Checker panel opens. Select the plus sign next to the table to expand its content. Now, all of the table properties pass. Setting the table with a little magic. Now, this is a tip for advanced users only. If you're proficient with table tags and their structure in HTML, you can skip the previous step and simply type in the tags tree to replace the correct TD tags with TH tags. But be very careful. A TH tag in the wrong cell may crash your table. You will also need to use the table editor to set the scope.
Now that we've properly defined our table headers, let's see how it sounds to a JAWS user.
Fruit price compare - Adobe Acrobat Pro DC. Column 2, row 2, HEB pairs, 1.29/LB. 1.49/LB. 1.19/LB. Column 4, row 2, Costco pairs, 1.19/LB. 2.79/LB. Column 5, row 2, Whole Foods pairs, 2.79/LB. Peaches, 1.89/LB. 1.93/LB. Column 3, row 3, Randall's peaches, 1.93/LB.
Summary. In this module, you learned how to remediate a simple table in Adobe Acrobat Pro by ensuring both the row header and the column header were properly tagged. In the upcoming modules, you will learn how to remediate a complex and a corrupted table inside of Adobe Acrobat Pro. This concludes our overview of Making Accessible PDF Tables, Part 2, How to Remediate a Simple Table.